moving to the next lines. Don't eat that chocolate, Amanda. Remember your acne, Amanda. Will you please look at me what I am speaking to you, Amanda? Now again, these lines are spoken by the mother. Amanda's mother is giving instructions to her. Again, she says, don't eat that chocolate, Amanda. Remember, you have acne and must be careful because chocolate can cause you more acne, pimples and all that. So the mother was giving instructions to Amanda not to eat that much chocolate now. She should be careful about herself. Amanda, will you please look for towards me when I am speaking to you? Because when we speak to somebody and the listener is not paying any attention, the second person is not paying any attention, then we forcefully say, like mother is saying, will you please look at me when I am speaking to you, Amanda? So she wants that Amanda should pay attention towards what I am speaking. So let us discuss few questions for RTC. Who is the speaker of these lines? Again, it's obvious. The mother is the speaker of these lines. You can say Amanda's mother. What is she asked not to do? She is asked not to eat chocolates because that can cause acne. She's also having the problem of acne. Why is eating chocolate harmful for her? Because she should not eat chocolate as she had pimples on her face, acne on her face. So where should she look when someone is talking to her? Obviously, she should look at the speaker. And here the speaker is the mother. The mother wants that she should look towards her when she is speaking to her, telling to her something. Moving to the next. Now again, these lines are in brackets. So this is the answer. Another imagination of, you can say, Amanda. I am Rapunzel. I have not a care. Life in a tower is tranquil and rare. I'll suddenly never let down my bright hair. Before I start with the meaning, okay, let us give the meaning of these lines first. Now, Amanda, instead of giving any attention, instead of paying any attention towards the questions asked by the mother, she is again lost in her imaginary world of dreams. You can say she imagines herself to be Rapunzel. Like the Rapunzel, particularly I am saying the word the, like her, she doesn't care for anybody who is speaking, who wants to advise her. No, she doesn't pay any attention. She doesn't care of anybody. She lives quietly alone in a tower like Rapunzel. She is in her own world. She pledges that she will never let her bright hair down. So now I tell you, what is the story of Rapunzel? Actually, it's a German fairy tale about a young woman, and the name and her name was Rapunzel. She was having impossibly long hair, and she lives all alone in a tower where she was held captured by a witch. It's actually a fairy tale. We don't know whether there is any truth behind the story, but because she remains in a single tower, so in a way we can say metaphorically, Amanda also lives in a tower, in a world of her own, in her dreams only. Come to the last lines. Stop that suckling. Before I move to the next, let us discuss some questions. Who is Rapunzel? It's a beautiful fairy living all alone in a tower, you can say. Who imagines herself as Rapunzel? Obviously Amanda, no one else. Only two characters are there in the poem. One is the mother, other is Amanda. Where does Rapunzel live? Rapunzel lives alone in a silent tower, leading a carefree life, a relaxed, a tranquil life. What decision does she take about her hair? She will never let her hair down. She won't allow anybody to touch or cut her hair. Stop that circling at once, Amanda. You are always so moody, Amanda. Anyone would think that I nagged at you, Amanda. Now again, The last lines are spoken by the mother. So the meaning of the lines are, Amanda's mother asked her not to look unhappy and sad. Don't feel unhappy. She should look a little more cheerful. Amanda has been very moody and of unstable nature. But she asked her again to look cheerful, otherwise people will think or people will blame her mother of nagging or troubling her continuously, torturing her all the time, directing her all the time, which she doesn't want. The mother doesn't want that people should think that I am torturing you, it's my duty, I'm just suggesting you, I'm advising you. So let us discuss the questions. What does she ask Amanda to stop at once? She asks Amanda to stop being sulky or unhappy or moody at once. Why does she call Amanda moody? Because she is a girl of shifting mood, unstable mind. She changes the decision very soon. Who is the speaker of these lines? Obviously, Amanda's mother is speaking these lines. She is the speaker. What would others say about Amanda's mother? If Amanda does not stop being unhappy, others will think, they may think that the mother has been nagging her continuously, mother has been torturing her continuously, mother has been troubling her continuously. So that's all about the RTC part. We will discuss some important questions of the poem and MCQs in the next video.